Yes, boys, you must know what is the anatomy and what you will read, okay? Anatomy is the branch of medical science. Backbenchers, are you listening me or not? Good. So it is the branch of medical science where you will study the different parts of the body by means of different ways or the different branch of the anatomy. For example, first of all we dissect the body, dissection karte hain body ka, and see the parts of the body and their position. For example, when we open the thoracic region, there you will read about the heart and lungs, right? Similarly, when we open the head region, you will read the different parts of the brain, and also in the neck region the different blood vessels and nerves. Like as we go to this region, this is called upper limb. This is called upper limb, where we again see the different muscles, joints and blood supply, that is including the artery and vein, and nerve supply, that includes the nerves. So like that we read the different parts of the body. This branch of anatomy is called gross anatomy, GROSS, gross anatomy. The gross anatomy is that part of anatomy where we will read the different parts of the body by means of dissection. Dissection is cutting the parts of the region of the body and see. Second part, we will read the part of the different parts of the body under microscope. That is called histology. That is the branch of anatomy, histology, in which we take that different part of the body tissue and make the slide, and that slide is focused under the microscope and we identify that part. That is the histology part. Another part, we see the different parts of the body by means of X-rays. As you people know this thing, that when the patient is ill, came to the doctor, doctor write if they want to see the parts of the body, whether it is affecting or not. For example, lungs X-ray, X-ray of the lungs. So we focus that part and take the skygram. X-ray is called skygram. Layman is using the word X-ray. The doctors are using the skygram, S-K-I-G-R-A-M, skygram. So that is the radiological part of anatomy. The third part, how the development takes place since from birth to the adult life. Different parts of the body, when this part develop, when this part develop, and how it grows. क्या कह रहे हैं एक मिनट हाँ बोलो
इंस्पेक्शन का बॉम्ब की मीटिंग की है सर तो आपका नाम देखवाऊंगी 71 पेज
कितने हैं
एक ही पेज है
एक ही पेज है तो लिया हो इधर रिजल्ट तो नहीं आया क्या अभी तक मैंने तो भेज दिया था पहले ही और कहीं बस देख लो आप 71 तो हो गया ना, एक ही
और
देख लो। ठीक, सो द इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट दैट हाउ द डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ द बॉडी डेवलप, दिस पार्ट ऑफ एनाटॉमी इज कॉल्ड एम्ब्रियोलॉजी। एम्ब्रियोलॉजी, शुड आई राइट द स्पेलिंग? EMBRYOLOGY और डेवलपमेंटल एनाटॉमी, द इम्पॉर्टेंट ब्रांच फॉर यू पीपल is arthrology, where you will read the different joints of the body and what are the movements taking place at these joints and the muscles responsible for these movements. That is called arthrology. All these structures, when you read the books, the terms which we use in the books, all these terminology are related to the anatomical position of the body. That means whatever we are using, that terms are concerned, consider the body is standing erect like this, in a standing position. These are the hands, the arms should be side of the body like this and hand should be face forward and both the feet in closed position and straightforward. This is called anatomical position, right? Line passing from center of the body to downwards to the ground, that is called midline. That is called midline. So if the movements are close to the midline, this is called adduction. If the movements is away from the midline like this, this is called abduction. Okay? Similarly in the feet, if the lower limb is away from the midline, that is called visible or not. If the lower limb is away from the midline, that is abduction. Similarly, this is adduction. Okay? So these are the movements. And another is, look here, I am standing in anatomical position, right? If I rotate my hand like this, this is called medial rotation. And if it is rotating like this, that is lateral rotation. Similarly, the rotational movements are taking place in the lower limb. So whatever the terms we use, suppose we are using the supine position. Supine positions, the different how the body is lying over the table or on the bed. In supine position, the person is lying or the body is lying over the table, the head is looking upwards. That is called supine. SUPINE, supine position. And just reverse to this, if his head is towards the, facing towards the table, that is called prone position, PRONE, prone position. Then another term which should be clear to you, proximal or distal. The proximal is used if we are using for our whole body. That means proximal is facing towards the head. Distal is downward. If the same term we use in the limbs, in upper limb, if I put here and I say that proximal, my finger is proximal, that means it is facing towards the shoulder joint or the head of the humerus. If it is facing downward, that means distal, away from the head of the humerus. The same term, if we used here in the trunk, facing towards the head, proximal, facing towards the feet, distal, and the different terms, the different branches of anatomy, as I told you, first is cross anatomy, second, histology. Histology is also named as microanatomy. Third, embryology. Also named as developmental anatomy. Radiological anatomy. Surface marking. Clinical anatomy. So these are the different branches of anatomy. Gross anatomy, that is the main, how we read the different parts of the body by means of dissection, that is called gross anatomy. In histology, we read the different tissue of the body under the microscope by using the slide. Third, developmental anatomy, embryology, in which we study the how the development takes place of different parts of the body. Radiological anatomy, where we study the different parts of the body by means of X-ray or the skygram. Surface anatomy, in which as you go in the DH, dissection hall, have you noticed that on one table there is a very dried cadaver is lying on. Bahut sukhi body cadaver ki rakhi hui hai table pe. On which, after teaching you, we teach that, suppose, what is the position of the heart? We know that it is lying in the thoracic region, in which intercostal space we will count the space, and for example, it is lying in the left thoracic region. Left thoracic region, the heart is present. We will teach you, wait, don't write. So it is lying in the left side of the thoracic region. Then we count the intercostal spaces. The apex of the heart is lying in the midclavicular line in fifth intercostal space. So when the doctor wants to auscultate, it means heart sound sunne ke liye, jab doctor stent lagata hai to kahan lagayega? Fifth intercostal space. Then you can hear the heart sounds by the stethoscope. So all these ideas, where after becoming doctor, if we want to auscultate, hum agar heart sound sunna chahte to stent kahan lagayenge? All these ideas are given by surface anatomy. Is it clear? भाई आपको अभी तो पता नहीं, तो आपको ये पढ़ाया जाएगा कि फिफ्थ इंटरकॉस्टल स्पेस और क्लेविकल, ये क्लेविकल है, इसका मिडिल पार्ट से आप नीचे आइए फिफ्थ इंटरकॉस्टल स्पेस में और इसके लेफ्ट साइड पे यहाँ पे स्टेथ लगाइए. देन यू कैन लिसन द हार्ट साउंड. सिमिलरली द लंग्स, लंग्स की आपको ऑस्कल्टेट करना है तो कैसे लंग्स की पोजीशन आपको पता होनी चाहिए. उसी जगह आप स्टेथ लगा के और पेशेंट से बोलोगे कफिंग. अंडरस्टैंड? सो इन सरफेस एनाटॉमी वी विल टीच यू द डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ द बॉडी, देयर पोजीशन अकॉर्डिंग टू द पार्ट ऑफ द सिस्टम. दैट ऑल थिंग्स विल बी टीच यू बाय सरफेस एनाटॉमी. So surface marking, rather it say that this is called surface anatomy. And another branch, here is the downward, so I am writing here, osteology. In which you will read the different bones of the body. Different bones of the body, that branch is called osteology. So these are the ways by which we will teach you. The clinical anatomy is in when we teach you by means of gross anatomy, then related to the part, we will also teach if there is a fracture of this part, what will be the position. If the muscle is injured, what will be the position patient comes, or nerve injury, so paralysis hoga, to kaisa movement hoga. All the things are related to the clinical anatomy. That means the part of the body is injured or affected, what will be the position of that part. All these things we will teach you in the clinical anatomy or applied anatomy, one and the same thing. Clinical anatomy or applied anatomy, both are the one and same thing. Then the way how we will teach, the teaching method, it is by the regional anatomy, region wise, or it can be by the systemic anatomy. Region wise, that suppose we will teach you first this part of the body. So this is the upper limb. So regional wise, like if we teach you the lower limb, again this is the regional anatomy. Thoracic region, abdominal region, neck region or head region. So all these are called regional anatomy. We will teach you according to regional anatomy, region wise. And third, second method is the systemic anatomy. That means teaching of anatomy according to system. For example, respiratory system, cardiovascular system, abdominal region, like that. So systemic part, we will rather, we are teaching you according to region wise. All right. So we must know about the region. Today I am just giving you introduction, nothing more. Region wise, for example, the limbs. The limbs of the body are upper limb, that is starting from shoulder joint to the hand. This is the upper limb. Upper limb, what you will read in the upper limb, have you noticed this is a bone, this is the scapula, and this is the shoulder joint where these movements are possible. This is the circumduction, and this is abduction, this is adduction, and this is the flexion, and this is extension. All these movements, they are taking place at the shoulder joint. Okay, this is flexion. Put your one hand here and do the movements. This is flexion and this is extension. When you will keep your hand here, you will find doing these flexion, extension, there is this part, head of the humerus is rotating. Okay, and this is the elbow joint. This elbow joint, that is the movement between the head of the humerus bone above and the forearm. This is the forearm from elbow to the wrist joint. This is the wrist joint. Okay, see first the joints. This is the shoulder joint. This is the elbow joint. And this is the wrist joint. Right? So, the bone which is lying between shoulder joint and elbow joint is the single bone of upper limb, that is humerus. From elbow joint to the wrist, there this part of the body is called forearm. This is called arm. This is forearm. In forearm there are the two bones. One is radial, lateral side, because away from the midline. This part is away from the midline, so this is called lateral. The lateral bone is the radius. So this is the radius. And medial bone, ulna. Okay? And in the hand, look here, the wrist joint is this joint. And at the wrist joint, there are the eight carpal bones. 8 carpal bones, which are present in proximal row, 4 bones, 4 carpal bones in the proximal row and 4 carpal bones in the distal row. All these 8 carpal bones are forming the wrist joint. Then we come to the hand. In the hand, you are seeing there are the 5 metacarpals. This is the first metacarpal, this is second metacarpal, third metacarpal, fourth, fifth. These are the metacarpals. And in the fingers, in the first part, there are the 2 phalanges. While in the rest of the fingers, there are the proximal, middle and distal phalanges, 3 phalanges. So they all are forming the hand. So in upper limb, we will teach you first of all the arm region, then forearm region like this. And the head of the humerus, look here, the bone of the arm is the humerus. The head of the humerus is articulating here with the scapula. So this is the scapula. And articulating with the, there is a cup shaped part of the scapula in which the head of the humerus is articulating. The articulation between the 2 bones or more than 2 bones is called joint. Look here, we are saying this is the shoulder joint. Shoulder joint is formed by the articulation between head of humerus and the glenoid cavity of the scapula. And that is forming the shoulder joint. The lower end of the humerus is articulating with the head of radius and the notch of the ulna. That is called elbow joint. Similarly, the wrist joint. So, the articulation between the 2 bones or more than 2 bones, as look here in the elbow joint, there are 3 bones. Lower end of the humerus, head of the radius and ulnar notch. So, 3 bones are there. Because of that, I am telling you, the articulation between 2 or more than 2 bones, maybe 3 or maybe 4, that is called joint. So in upper limb, you will read like this. Similarly, in the lower limb, this is the hip joint. And this is the knee joint. And similarly, downward, there is the ankle joint. The part of the lower limb between hip joint and knee joint, this is called thoracic region. This is called thoracic region. And similarly, lower down, this is the knee joint and this is the ankle joint. The part of the lower limb between the knee joint and ankle joint, this is called leg. This is called leg. And below the ankle joint, this is called foot. This is called foot. And see, as I am putting my here, this is the dorsal surface of the foot. And this is the plantar surface of the foot, downward. This is plantar surface of the foot and this is the dorsal surface of the foot. In the hand, this is the dorsal surface of the hand and this is the palmar surface of the hand. Okay? The bones of the thigh, that is called femur, the bone of the thigh region. You know the thigh region, that is the part of the lower limb between hip joint and knee joint. There is a single bone similar to the upper limb of the arm. The bone of the lower limb thigh region is the femur. And in the leg region, the medial bone, that is this side. The medial bone is the tibia and lateral bone is the fibula. And in the ankle joint, similar to the wrist joint, there are the tarsal bones, and these tarsal bones are calcaneum, talus, like that, cuneiforms. So all we will teach you like that. So this is the part how we teach you, then come into the thoracic region or in the trunk. In the trunk, this part of the trunk below the head, this is the head, below the head and above the thorax, this is called neck region. This complete is the neck region, and above this part, that is called head region. So we will teach you this part in the head and neck region. In the head and neck region, what you will reach? Neck region and head, complete part of the head, face, ear, eyes, nose, oral cavity, like this. And inside the skull, there is, you will reach the different parts of the brain. The bone of the head region, that is called skull, S-K-U-L-L, skull. The layman using this word as khopri. Understand? So in the skull lying the brain. So in head and neck region, we will teach you all these things. Okay, then come to the thoracic region. The thoracic region below the neck region and downward, it is the thoracic region. And below this region, what is the bone of the thoracic region? In the center, there is the sternum. And articulating the sternum, there are the ribs. There are the ribs. So anteriorly, the ribs are articulating with the sternum, and posteriorly, they are articulating with the part of the vertebral column. The lower part, this is the abdomen, but there is no continuation of the thoracic region and abdomen. Both are separated from each other by the diaphragm. Look here, the diaphragm is just like not a cover, but it is a muscle which separates. The lower part is the abdomen region and upper part is the thoracic region. So the thoracic region is separated from the abdominal region by means of diaphragm. What is the diaphragm? That is a muscle, muscular sheet. And as we come down, the abdomen is also dividing into two regions. The proper abdominal region and come down, that is the part of pelvis. So that we will teach you like region wise. The another thing which I want to tell you, how many students bring the or come in the apron? I have seen that many of you, those who students who have no apron today, start coming with apron on next time. I will send you today in the DH where you will sit there and the person will teach you the same thing, because once you will wear the apron, then we start. Oh, I wish that from the next Monday onwards, all will be in the apron, because now we will start the different general anatomy. In general anatomy, first of all, we will teach you about the different part, like the systemic anatomy and the muscular, the different type of the muscles you will see in the body. We classify the muscles according to muscles which are mainly responsible for the movement. Some muscles are smooth muscles and some are skeletal muscles. So we classify. So we will take the class detail, general class of muscles, joints, nerve supply, blood supply, and joints,